Hi, everybody. Well, this is our video for our skeletal system doodle notes, and there's a lot in here, so I'm actually going to break the video into several smaller videos so that way I can actually upload them. So in my first video, I'm going to do this first page, then this one about long bones, and this one about spongy and compact bone. And I'll make another video for the other later. So first, the skeletal system functions. Pause in a second to make sure you have time to get there. So first, I'm going to start with this S up here. And that S stands for support, as in it helps to hold up your body weight. And supports all of the other things that get attached to it. P is protection. It protects some of your organs. Like your lungs, your brain, etc. And your spinal cord, too, which isn't really an organ. I guess you could probably call it an organ if you want to. S on this side is storage. That pen does not want to work. Thunder one. Storage, as in stores minerals like calcium and also fats in the yellow bone marrow. M down at the bottom here is for manufacturing. Because it creates blood cells in the red marrow. And our last M is movement. Muscles pull on the bones, which cause the joints to bend, etc. Alrighty, here's the whole thing. Leave that there for a second. Up next is the one that says long bone structure. This. So I'm going to go down one side and then down the other. Make it a little easier for you guys to see. At the top here, it's pointing to this area, which is your spongy bone. And spongy bone is a lattice, they're called trabeculae. It is filled with marrow. We're going to see more about spongy bone in the next one that we do. So that's good for now. Hang on a second. Easier to see. Plus, I'm gonna do some coloring. Just a little bit. So the spongy bone is pointing to these areas. There's also some down here. Up next is compact bone. And in compact bone, we have osteons arranged in circles around that central canal. It's called the Haversian canal, if you want to get fancy. And that would be this outer part along here. Not the border, because that would be the periosteum, what we're going to get to in a second. You can kind of continue it up into here, because it would be kind of up along here too. There we go. I'm only coloring a little bit so that we can have time to do all this. The next one down is pointing to this empty part in the middle, which is your medullary cavity. And this is, it opens as a cavity, but you find in there the bone marrow. Anything purple here at the moment, so I'll just leave that one empty for now. This one's pointing to this thing inside. There we go. Which is the yellow marrow. We don't really see the red marrow in this, but the red marrow can be there and it can also be up within the spongy bone. And it stores fat, whereas the red marrow is where the blood cells are made. So here we go. Obviously, it would fill up most of this cavity. Do that to attach them together, but they have it cut open here so you can see all the different parts. And this last one's pointing to this noodly thing, which is a blood vessel. An artery. Because remember, bones have blood vessels going through them. That's why it's a big deal when you break them. And side note here, human blood is always red. Whoever told you blood is blue, they're idiots. They don't know what they're talking about. You'll get to hear that rant more when we do the circulatory system. Over here. This one's pointing to this top end, which we know we call, color I haven't used yet. Epiphysis, or the end. There'd also be one down at the other end, but we're just seeing this end right now. This is pointing to this border line here, which is a big different color, so I can match it up here. I'm just gonna clean the black pen here. This is your epithelial line, or the growth plate. We'll see more about this when we do the page that's about creating bone. This is actually pointing to the outside, which is a little bit confusing because it's kind of like in there. The dot doesn't really line up exact. But that would be the periosteum or periosteum. The periosteum is the outer layer, and it connects the bone to your skin or tendons or whatever it needs to connect to. It's going to connect it to. That would actually be this here. I'm not going to do the whole thing, but I'll do a little bit on both sides. You kind of see what I mean. And we go all the way up around too. I'm just not coloring it all in to save us a little time here in our video. The next one down is talking about this whole middle shaft part. That is our diaphysis. The shaft of the bone. And our last one is pointing toward the bottom. That is our articular cartilage. And we find that wherever we have a joint to help kind of reduce friction between two bones coming together. Let's see, what color haven't I used yet? Yeah, the brown here. I'll use brown for my articular cartilage. There would be some at the other end too, but it was cut away to show you the spongy bone, so. There you go. Let's move it here. Do a quick pass over of the whole thing. Alrighty, one more for this video. And that will be this one that says spongy bone on top. I lost my key. So this spongy bone, this top one is pointing toward this lattice, which are called the trabeculae. Which is the lattice part. It is the calcified part of the bone, and it helps to make bone lighter, because if you have some spongy bone in there, then the bone isn't solid all the way through and it's a little bit less dense. So if you'd like to color it in, it's basically this whole thing. Except this here would be a blood vessel, this darker line, and this one down here is pointing to the hole, so you'd basically just color in this whole thing if you want to. The holes, which doesn't really have a fancy name, we're just calling them holes. They are filled with bone marrow and, as you can see here, blood vessels. So if you'd like to, leave that there for a second, let everybody catch up. You could go like this and color in the holes to show your red bone marrow, etc. And then your trabeculae would be all of these things. I just colored in a small part, but you can color in the whole thing if you'd like to. These are your doodle notes, made to help you study, so. Go down to compact. So one on the top is pointing to an osteon.
Well, come on, Pen. There we go.
And these are the rings. They're kind of like a cylinder going down through. Or the Haversian canal, if you want to get fancy. So this here is one osteon. In the picture next to it, we are going to be looking at it under a microscope view. This is kind of what you saw when we did the tissues. Now, this one is pointing to the rings. This one is pointing to the space in between the rings. They both have fancy names, but I'm not going to get that caught up with them. So, we'll call that the matrix in between the osteons. And we're going to call this the matrix around the central cone, or the matrix that's inside of the osteon. So here's the difference. Look at this one in blue. We're talking about like this area. Goes a little bit down here. This area is kind of like in between the circles. As matrix around the canal, it's like this part. And there's also ones over here. So when you look at the histology and the tissues in bone, they do differentiate between the parts that are osteons and the parts that aren't. So that's basically what's going on here. All right, I'm gonna stop here, and new video will be for the next ones. So stay tuned.